So we're here in Louis Armstrong Park, which was the original site of Congress Square. And this that we're sitting in right here is the memorial area that is dedicated to the remembrance of Congress Square. And what's so important about the square is that New Orleans was the only place in America that allowed the slaves to practice their religion, dance, and song. And that was all here, right here, Congress Square. This was a gathering place and a market for the Houma Indians. And then once the slaves started being brought here, then they were brought here to gather as well on the Sundays. So you get all these African rhythms, all this African song and culture, and it's being harbored and preserved right here. And so what happened was in the 1850s, right around the time of the Civil War, there was a law passed that now disallowed the playing of drumming in the city limits. So people started playing hand percussion in some of the local haunts right around here in these areas that surround the square. A lot of this was happening in Treme, which is the area right outside the square that is the first black neighborhood in America. And so all these rhythms, African rhythms, being played now on tambourines and cowbells and bottles and anything that you can find to hit, these rhythms started to develop into the Mardi Gras Indian tradition. And that whole tradition is the blending of the African culture with some of the Native American culture and some of the sewing and dress that came from Haiti and some of the Indian ideas. So these rhythms and this notion of dressing up and masking, but working on your suit all year long to parade on Mardi Gras Day, this tradition is still alive today. And all these rhythms permeate R&B and permeate jazz and all the types of music that have come out of New Orleans. So this Congress Square tradition became the Mardi Gras Indian tradition, but then it also became the second line tradition when you have the parades that are parading through the streets of New Orleans for funeral processions, and these were all being played on European instruments with trumpets, trombones, clarinet at the time, now it's saxophone, and snare drum and bass drum, and they started off playing a type of European march and Civil War march, and then eventually those marches got infiltrated with and combined and commingled with the African rhythms. And so what you get is European marches infused with African rhythm, and that starts to become the whole second line tradition. And the second line is referring to the funeral procession, in where the hearse and the body are in the first line, and you don't want to be in the first line. So the second line is the band and the friends and family, the mourners, and then all the people who come out of the haunts and the local bars and establishments and the houses and literally come off the streets and join in the procession. So this whole procession that's parading through the streets is called the second line. It also refers to second line music, second line drumming. So this entire culture that was preserved here in Congress Square turned into the Mardi Gras Indian thing, turned into the second line, and all those things have permeated New Orleans music, which has now permeated all of Western music as we know it. So if you like a backbeat, and it could be in, that could be in jazz, or that could be in funk, that could be in hip hop, that could be in heavy metal, that could be in country and Western music, the backbeat is in all Western music, and all of that is coming from here in Congress Square and New Orleans and permeating out into all Western popular music as we know it.